I think it comes down to a question of personal values. And I think everybody has to look at the things they do all day long, from the time they get up to the time they go to bed, and look at everything they do all day long, and thereby examine their lifestyle. Most people feel fairly secure with where they live in this part of the world, and their food supply is pretty secure. Nobody's worried about running out of food in hardly anywhere in Europe. In general, I am making sweeping statements, but I think there's a general mood compared to 100 years ago. And the question is, how have we all become accustomed over these last two generations or so to live our lives? Obviously, we all want to have choice of what we eat every day. I mean, you know, it wouldn't be a good meal if I didn't have, you know, a range of ingredients. I don't want to eat what I ate yesterday. I had that yesterday. I need something different today. Well, actually, I had that 3 or 4 days. I want something different every day of the week. And I need about 100 different ingredients. Otherwise, well, it's a pretty poor supply, isn't it? And to gain access to 100 different ingredients every week, whatever it is, I need a supermarket type of supply chain. I need global input. I need things from all over the world. And I need those things fairly cheap, too. I don't want to spend too much, more than 10% of my average income paying for it. Of course, 30 years ago, 40 years ago, we spent 30%. And 50 years ago, we spent 50% of our income paying for food. We probably had a lot less variety. Food, relative to everything else, has become cheaper and cheaper year by year. Technology has led to some of that, particularly technology that replaces labor. So the labor doesn't work on the land very much anymore, except for people who are very poor, have a very low income prospect, and they're obliged to work at relatively low wages, hard working conditions, mostly imported labor in this part of the world, and increasingly in the United States, for instance. Long distance transportation seems to be free. Now, I don't quite understand that. It's not free when I want to travel around the world, but it's free for a ton of carrots to travel 1,000 miles, and the cost is much lower than the cost of producing them here, which seems an anomaly to me. It seems crazy to me.